NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency teamed up to build the James Webb Space Telescope, and it is now the most powerful telescope ever created. This is one of the most exciting periods in astronomical history. Join us as we learn some amazing facts about the James Webb Space Telescope. What they did wrong. The James Webb Space Telescope did so many things wrong from an engineering standpoint. The first rule of building a long-duration, highly technical object that has to launch into space atop a continuously exploding and shaking, potentially bomb, propelling it beyond Earth orbit, is to have no moving parts, or at least as few as possible. At launch, there are far too many opportunities for something to be damaged, displaced, jammed, or destroyed, rendering the whole project a complete loss. All told, the James Webb Space Telescope had many single points of failure that could render the telescope useless and unrecoverable. Stunning success. Originally named the Next Generation Space Telescope, it was renamed the James Webb Space Telescope, or JWST. After James Webb, who was the administrator of NASA, the agency's highest position in the 1960s. With superb engineering and many delays and cost overruns, the James Webb Space Telescope was built by NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency over roughly 20 years. Its total cost will eventually reach the equivalent of $10.8 billion from all the contributors from construction to the end of the first 5 years of operation. The Webb launched on December 25th, 2021 and reached its final orbit on January 24th, 2022, about 1.5 million kilometers from Earth. Due to unbelievably good launch control, so much fuel was preserved that what was to be a 5 to 10 year mission now has the potential to last for over 2 decades. That will permit an amazing amount of research to be completed well beyond expectations. Technical wizardry. Extraordinary engineering checked and rechecked to make sure all the parts would work. There were tiny locking pins that had to release once it reached orbit. There were latches that had to connect to hold it together. There were dozens of motors that had to operate in precisely the right way. Just the heat shield alone took from December 31st to January 4th to be fully deployed. On January 24th, 2022, Webb reached its permanent orbit out at the so-called L2 point, where it could maintain its position with only a tiny amount of fuel expenditure. Since then, all of the armatures, instruments, and mirrors have properly deployed. Now, micro-actuators will painstakingly aim the 18 individual mirrors over the course of many months so that they all focus on one spot. To understand the intricacy, it helps to know that each mirror has 6 motors to aim it, and a central one to alter the curvature of each mirror to achieve perfect focus. With over 120 motors just on the main mirror, this is not a process that can be rushed because an error could necessitate a complete refocusing, taking many more months and even last the lifetime of the telescope. What is L2? There are 5 gravitational nodes that exist around 2 bodies, such as the Earth and the Sun in this case, where gravity and centrifugal force equal out. They are called Lagrange points and are ideal for placing something that you want to stay in one general place while minimizing fuel consumption used for station keeping. For example, we place solar observatories at L1 so they get a good view of the Sun. L2, on the other hand, sees far less of the Sun and is thus best for infrared astronomy. Webb will orbit around the L2 point while also staying in perfect unison with the Earth as it orbits around the Sun. From L2, Webb never loses contact with Earth. The transmission can reach us in less than 5 seconds, making a 10-second round trip time. Despite that, it is still safely isolated from a majority of reflected infrared light, meaning it takes a lot less effort to keep it cool. First light. What you can see from this first image, called the initial alignment mosaic, is that each mirror is recording its unique view of the same single star. an amazing mechanical ballet will gradually align what are essentially 18 individual telescopes into one giant telescope with a resolution nearly 9 times brighter and more detailed than Hubble Telescope can achieve. Better images result because Hubble's mirror is just 1.5 humans tall and wide, where Webb's is 4 humans tall and wide, giving it 7.5 times the light gathering ability just from sheer size. Since it is beryllium coated with gold, it is more efficient at collecting that infrared light than Hubble's glass and aluminum mirror. It should gather about 9 times as much light as the Hubble. We've already isolated each image of that star and identified which segment is producing it. Most are still smeared and distorted as they're not focused yet. It will take several months to consolidate the image into the spectacular precision and accuracy we are fully expecting to achieve. Why study infrared light? Visible light is a natural bias for humans because it brings so much of our daily information to us. Unfortunately, since the universe is expanding and expanding even faster the farther away from us it is, distant light gets stretched, making its frequency longer and longer until it drops out of the visible spectrum and becomes infrared. To see the oldest, farthest galaxies, we need to examine infrared light. The Hubble Space Telescope can make limited observations in the near-infrared band of light, but was designed primarily for visible light and ultraviolet light. It is constrained by how far and accurately it can look into the infrared. Heat leakage into its receptors blinds it to longer wavelengths. It is like trying to see the flame of a lit match held up in front of a searchlight. The background is overwhelming. Webb will mostly study infrared light from very distant and faint objects. Made in the shade. Infrared light is a type of heat radiation, so the instruments on Webb will need to be kept very cold in order to detect these extremely faint heat signals. Webb uses a large sun shield to keep the telescope in permanent shade. This allows its temperature to drop down to negative 370 degrees Fahrenheit, negative 223 Celsius, or 50 Kelvins. The shield is composed of 5 layers of infrared-resistant film, each roughly the area of a tennis court. They are separated by the vacuum of space, the best insulator, which prevents infrared light, aka heat, from the sun, earth, or moon from reaching the telescope's vital components. The layers are constructed of aluminum-coated Kapton, similar to the material used to make space blankets. It's tough, resilient to the space environment, and extremely lightweight. Layers are separated by exact spacing to make sure this works, and the first layer is especially doped with silicon to make it even more infrared proof, which is why it is purple, while the rest are silver. All told, there are nearly 600 degree Fahrenheit difference between the hot side and cold side of the shield. And with additional cooling from a Pulse 2 pre-cooler and a liquid helium cryo-cooler transferring heat to a radiator, we can drop the temperature to negative 448 degrees Fahrenheit, negative 267 degrees Celsius, or just 6 Kelvins above absolute zero. The lowest temperature possible, where all molecular motion ceases for one specific instrument. Doesn't orbit Earth. The Hubble Space Telescope is in Earth's orbit at 340 miles, 550 kilometers. This orbit was chosen so we would have the capability of conducting servicing missions with the space shuttle. We visited 5 times to perform repairs, replaced instruments, and upgrade the machine. Hubble has thus done its job for more than 3 decades because NASA had the ability to service it. Webb, on the other hand, is in a stable solar orbit all of its own. It is so far away, 5 times further than the moon, that we won't have the option of servicing missions until we eventually get established on the moon properly. This is why Webb took 2 decades, cost billions, and was made to be so robust. In the next decade, we're planning a lunar orbiting crewed service station, looking to develop scientific outposts on the lunar surface and to build some minimal infrastructure there. After that, with faster spacecraft, we could service Webb. Until then, however, Webb has to be entirely self-reliant. Coming soon. Like the Hubble Space Telescope, when it first went into service, there are going to be incredible surprises that no one has predicted. That would be impossible to predict now because we lack information. That's the best part about science. It is always going to teach us something new by building on things we already know. What about the James Webb Space Telescope do you find most interesting? Let us know in the comments below, and then check out this next video that you might enjoy. Thanks for watching.